Hello YouTube and Airsoft Canada. This is Conflict 6, another Airsoft video review for you. Today, I'll be reviewing the Remington TAC-1 pump action shotgun. I got this for Christmas because that shotgun right there broke. Still, you could still use it, but the trigger doesn't work. I tried to fix it. No luck. This is a Remington TAC-1 shotgun from Bass Pro Shop. My parents ordered it from there for me. This is what the box says. TAC-1 shotgun. 6-point adjustable stock. Magazine. 240 rounds. And quick feed dial or wind up magazine. Slam fire. Adjustable hop-up system, and top over there, four mounting nails, and here are the specs. Mechanism spring, 6mm, the stock magazine can hold up 240 BBs, weight about 4.2 pounds, barrel aluminum, maximum velocity 350 feet per second. It has a bunch of advertisements for other Crossman products because this is a Crossman product. It's a runoff of a Crossman product. And here is the gun itself. As you can see, you have the stock. Okay. Really nice shotgun. I'll go from parts front to back. I mean, back to front. The stock is plastic. And it has 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can remove it. I don't know if you can see this. Right here, just pull this out and pull back on the stock, and boom, you have removed your stock. But there's no really reason for that. And the buffer tube is plastic. It does have a big weight in it, but it's not hollow plastic. It's really good quality ABS. The plastic body and a plastic hand grip, plastic trigger system, all really durable. Then you have your internal barrel, right there, which is aluminum. Then you have your, I don't know what this is called, your pump guider, I don't know. It's metal and has a nice big weight in there. And your pump is plastic, textured plastic though. And this piece right here, going from your pump handle to your piston, is metal. And for the front, you have your orange tip. You have your you could unscrew that right there to take out like your barrel and stuff. And you have a metal sling mount. And the metal sling mount held up by leather or something. No, not leather. Metal. Wow. Looks like leather, but doesn't feel like it. You have your adjustable hop-up system. Back is normal. Front is hop. I don't know if you can see. It says normal. Normal. Hop. And see, this one's broken, so I used the mags from this one and this shotgun. Here's the stock magazine. There's some wobble. I don't know if you could see the wobble, but there's some wobble. I don't really like the high cap because you never reload, and I kind of like reloading. Yeah, it's just a wind up. You put your BBs in there. They feed out of right there. Holds about 240. Don't use that mag. Get some low cap magazines. They feed 100%. And they hide the look of them. I have 5 of them. And that's for the magazine. And like the small ones don't wiggle. Oh, there's some play, but not as much as the high cap. But and here's your rail system. You have a rail on the side for your flashlight, laser rail, a sight. You could put a red dot, whatever you want. This little back rail over here, because I was thinking if you like take this rail off, you still want a sight. And you can mount it back here. I'm not sure. But I'm gonna set up my camera. I'm holding it right now. The stock is in all the way. Stock's in all the way. This is it all the way out. As you can see, quite a far reach. And to pump it, just grab the pump, back, forward, the trigger, right there. And your safety is also right there. Push it, you're safe, push it out, fire. Thoughts is that it's a really good shotgun. The hop-up's a bit weird, but just use on 0.25 gram BBs, and your BBs will be flying straight and far for a while. And I've gamed this shotgun once, and it's really, really good. Like, one of the games was on the 26th of December, and we're in a scenario, and my AK battery ran out. And I ran back to the headquarters and I picked up this and I ran around with it, got a couple kills. But as you can see, I'm just going to do a comparison. This is the, what's it called? M3000 Smith & Wesson. They have the exact same thing, but this one has a different spring in there. And this one is obviously sawed off. Like, this one still works. I'll show you. The trigger doesn't work, and I had to. This came off, so I had to screw it back in there. I would recommend this gun as a backup gun, not a primary gun, because it's a Springer. And, especially if you're a sniper or something, I recommend this gun for a nice backup gun. And Crossman, if this breaks, Crossman has great customer support. You just call the agency, give them that code right there, and they'll know the make and model and whatever, and they'll talk it over with them. They'll send you a replacement or parts to fix it. And, yeah, so that's just the review of the Remington TAC-1 airsoft shotgun. And I'm just going to do a little update on my armory. These are my two shotguns. And over here, got my same old MXC-11 with homemade silencer. AK, the silencer and upgrades, mags, BBs, all that stuff. And that's it for now. If you have any questions about this gun, please ask them. Comment, rate, subscribe, favorite. And that's my video for today. Thank you. Have a great day.